One variable in total hip replacement wear testing that can be overlooked is test fluid composition and environment. In our first video, we mentioned that the ISO and ASTM standards differ greatly in the requirements for test fluids. To summarize, both ISO 14242 specs call for the use of bovine serum. However, -1 requires a protein concentration of 30 grams per liter, while -3 calls for a concentration no less than 17 grams per liter. On the other end of the spectrum, ASTM F1714 makes no suggestion regarding test fluid concentration.
The purpose of test solution for wear studies is to mimic the in vivo conditions of the human body as closely as possible, so that the results will give manufacturers and reviewers an accurate depiction of expected wear rates when implants are under normal operating conditions.
So how and to what extent does the test fluid used affect overall wear results? Various independent studies have been conducted to provide insights into this question, and while no solid consensus has been reached, various trends have been observed.
Wear test solution containing bovine serum, as required by the ISO specs, is generally considered to be more analogous to the fluid in human joints when compared to saline, distilled, and deionized water. Beyond this, the protein concentration of bovine serum can have a significant impact on the wear rates of implants.
Studies have shown that the highest wear rates were discovered using a medium protein concentration, around 50%. When the concentration was lowered, PE transfer was believed to have created an artificial film between the head and the liner that slowed wear action.
Conversely, higher concentrations of protein more easily precipitate out of the solution when degraded, causing artificial lubrication between the polyethylene bearing and femoral head, resulting in artificially lowered wear rates.
Fluid temperature is another potential variable affecting wear rates because temperature is a dictating factor on how much protein precipitates from the fluid. When temperatures are elevated, more protein precipitates, which causes an artificial barrier between the liner and the bearing. This barrier could also artificially decrease reported wear rates.
So how do you decide what test fluid to use for your study? The most important consideration is to determine what concentration and temperatures most accurately reflect in vivo loading conditions, or what concentrations and temperatures were used in the studies that you're trying to compare to.
In addition, it's critical to ensure the predicate devices are tested side by side, using the same test fluid to decrease potential variables and allow for accurate comparisons between devices.
If you have any questions about what we just covered or any other testing needs, feel free to contact us.
Stay tuned for the next video in our hip wear testing series, where we will discuss yet another potential variable and how to minimize the effects.